Did you know that butterflies have receptors that allow them to taste using their feet? Or that their taste buds are 200 times stronger than humans? Did you also know that there's a type of shark that glows in the dark? Or that koalas can sleep a total of up to 20 hours a day? Can you imagine how interesting life would be if we had characteristics similar to some of these animals? All living organisms are different from each other and have evolved over many years to survive as they interact in their environment and with other species. Scientists use the term population to define all members of one species that can reproduce and live in the same area. An example of a population that interacts with an environment is all the white-tailed deer that live in a forest. White-tailed deer are all the same species. They interact with each other and they reproduce with each other. We call one species of the same organism a population. A community is different from a population because it is made up of two or more species living in an area. For example, if you were to visit the White River National Forest in Colorado, you would see various living things interacting with each other. You may experience the smell of juniper and blue spruce and see populations of deer, elk, mountain lions, and various species of bees. This is a community because you have various living things that occupy and reside in an area. Ecosystems are different from communities because they're made up of living and non-living things. A swamp, an ocean, and a forest are all examples of ecosystems. In an ecosystem, you will find living things such as animals, bacteria, and plants, but also non-living things such as rocks, air, water, sunlight, and shelter. Scientists refer to all living things as biotic and all non-living things as abiotic. In an ecosystem, organisms live in communities with different species where they are interdependent, where they need each other and the environment they live in to survive. Most of the energy that enters an ecosystem is in the form of sunlight. Plants absorb light energy and convert it to food through a chemical process known as photosynthesis. Since plants make their own food and don't depend on another living organism, they're considered producers. A producer is any organism that has the ability to produce its own food. Consumers are organisms that depend on other organisms for food. There are three types of consumers: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Herbivores are organisms that eat plants, seeds, or fruit to survive. For example, a butterfly, ant, snail, koala, deer, and a horse all depend on different plants to survive. Carnivores are organisms that mostly eat other animals and insects to survive. Some carnivores include sharks, lions, hyenas, polar bears, frogs, and snakes. These all eat other animals for survival. Omnivores are organisms that eat both plants and other animals to survive. Some examples of omnivores include grizzly bears, groundhogs, snapping turtles, hedgehogs, monkeys, and humans. These organisms eat both plants and animals to survive. Decomposers are made up of bacteria and fungi and are also important in an ecosystem. They're tiny organisms that break up dead animals and plants for food. Producers, consumers, and decomposers are all part of an ecosystem where they depend on each other to transfer energy and survive. For example, a deer depends on plants to survive. Without plants, a deer wouldn't have any food to eat. There are also many animals that depend on deer as a source of food in an ecosystem. Some carnivores that eat deer include wolves, bears, and mountain lions. Decomposers also play an important role in breaking up dead organisms and recycling nutrients back into an ecosystem. In an ecosystem, organisms also need non-living things to survive. An animal or insects might use a rock for shelter. Non-living elements such as water, carbon dioxide, oxygen, sunlight, and rocks are all important for organisms to survive in an ecosystem. Let's review what we learned. Scientists use the term population to define all members of one species living in an area. A community is made up of two or more species living in a particular area. Ecosystem is a community of organisms that live in a habitat and depend on each other, along with the non-living components that make up an environment. Living things in an ecosystem, such as plants, animals, bacteria, and fungi, are called biotic factors. Non-living things such as rocks, soil, air, and water are called abiotic factors. In an ecosystem, you will find producers, consumers, and decomposers. Producers create their own food, such as plants that use sunlight as a source of energy. Consumers depend and eat other organisms to survive. There are three types of consumers: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Herbivores consume plants as a form of energy. Carnivores consume meat, and omnivores eat both plants and meat to survive. Decomposers are tiny organisms that break up dead animals and plants for food. Thank you for watching. See you next time.